Hello. Now this is my turn to welcome you all to the 6th CGS-M.U.N conference that is actually organized to our school. Honorable delegates, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of my school, I welcome you all to the 6th CGS-M.U.N conference and I thank you for participating in this special event. Our beloved ex-colleague, Mrs. Piliakou, who's not with us any longer, was the first to organize successful conferences. And we feel we are obliged to continue this tradition. On the other hand, it is addressed to young people, and this is one of the most important extracurricular activities a school can offer. Throughout the organization of this event, my colleague, Mrs. Vasia Saravelaki, and I have had the opportunity to work with a great number of students who are not only special, gifted, and talented, but also willing to share their experience with us. We have learned a lot. We have worked hard. But the most important thing was that we have had the pleasure of working with young people whose interest in world issues and world affairs goes far beyond their daily schedule and schoolwork. We also feel grateful for the tremendous help and support we have received by two excellent and very kind people, two experienced and motivated members of the MUN community, Lefteris Karichimakis and Yvonne Evstathiou. Thank you very much. Personally, as a teacher, I must express my admiration for all MUN members for their ability not only to speak excellent English and other languages, but discuss, express their opinions, and support them with strong arguments, as well as comprehensively negotiate matters of political, social, economic, and humanitarian nature. In this way, they motivate all of us to see the world from many different perspectives. I am certain that at the end of this conference, we will have become more aware of and sensitive to the problems that affect ourselves and the world around us. We will have become more knowledgeable and more open-minded, more sensitive, more caring, more skeptical, perhaps. We will have been more able to interpret events which occur around us and may become brave enough to overcome our fears and take decisions that will change our lives forever. We are at the dawn of a new era. We are faced with new challenges, and we must be prepared to respond to them. We must have the courage to fight for our rights and protect the values and principles we were raised with. We must respect the past and work diligently for the future. Dear delegates, you have already gone to great lengths towards shaping the future ahead of your time. Through your research, you have become acquainted with issues concerning war, environment, pollution, weapons, nuclear weapons, overpopulation, intolerance, racism, xenophobia, violation of human rights, and the most recent one, the world economic crisis. Will the world be like a tower that is falling apart? Are its foundations strong enough to withstand the pressure under which we all live in? And if we fight, shall we succeed? You, dear delegates, tomorrow's leaders, politicians, diplomats, citizens of the world, you may provide us with solutions and suggestions to all these and viable solutions to the problems that we have actually mentioned. However, the 6th CGS-M.U.N conference has not only been organized with a view to providing solutions and suggestions to all the above issues, but also help discover more things about the problem of refugees or asylum seekers, as actually the number of whom constantly increases. During our conference, you will have the opportunity to discover why the number of refugees on a worldwide basis is constantly increasing. You will exchange ideas, draw your own conclusions on how the international community can help. We will all become aware of and for how unfortunate somebody is when the world around him or her has collapsed, when he or she is forced to seek asylum to a new land which is not always friendly and hospitable. And it is then when the struggle for survival begins. And this struggle may be even more difficult than war itself. It's not known how long this war will last, and it's not known if homelessness, poverty, hunger will ever cease, the days of prosperity will return. Will people ever regain their self-esteem, self-respect, and return to a decent life that poverty has deprived them of? The world can be a hostile place, and those who are in power do not realize that it is people who have the power. And as for the definition of what decent life is, it's not only having the basics, but having a vision and having power to turn this vision into reality. So, honorable delegates, you're all present today because you have a dream to make your own contribution to world peace, unity, and justice. Not your only student, but in the future, you may be the ones to represent your country's rights and fight for its future. I wish you good luck with your resolutions, enjoy your conference, work together, find your allies, and send a message to the world. The world should be a place where we can all live together in peace. Thank you, chairs, delegates, admin staff, school staff, the very hardworking English department, my department, parents, M.U.N. secretary, and school administration for the dedication towards making this M.U.N. conference a reality. I also have to thank you, Mrs. Vasilios and Mrs. Pakas, because they have always been there when we needed them. And finally, I have to thank Mr. Gitona Senior and Mr. Gitona Junior, who encouraged us to actually work for this conference in a 6th consecutive period. Thank you all, good luck, and have a good time.